In June this year, Air India Flight 171 crashed immediately after takeoff. The investigators quickly recovered the two black boxes and have just released a preliminary report, which states the aircraft achieved the maximum recorded airspeed of 180 knots, and immediately thereafter, Engine 1 and Engine 2 fuel cutoff switches transitioned from run to cutoff. In the cockpit voice recording, one of the pilots is heard asking the other, "Why did he cut off?" To which the other pilot responded, "He did not do so." Whilst analysis of the two black boxes that are typical on board most commercial aircraft can give us an idea of what may have happened, one thing they can't tell us is why.
So surely having a third black box, one that video records everything that goes on inside a cockpit, would help answer those questions. And should it be enforced that every commercial airliner always has a camera recording everything that happens on the flight deck? As you can imagine, this is a pretty hotly debated topic right now in aviation. So let's have a look at the reasons why recording everything that happens on the flight deck is a good thing. Some of the reasons why doing that might not necessarily be a good thing. But also let's take a look at how general aviation might actually be setting the trend here.
I usually don't talk about air crash investigation content here on this channel because I am not an official air crash investigator, and I truly believe that you should only get your information on what's happened in air incidents from the official reports, not from the opinion of some random person here on YouTube. However, I will be referring to a couple of incidents in the past just to help make the point, because this is a discussion not about the specific incidents themselves, but what could potentially happen to the world of aviation in the future with some technological changes that we might see coming in the world of black boxes. And to start doing that, first of all, we need to take a look at what black boxes actually are. Modern commercial aircraft typically have two black boxes. Well, actually, they're not black, they're normally orange. And in some instances, there's not actually two, they're combined into one. But for the purpose of this video, think about them as two separate black boxes. First of all came the FDR, or the Flight Data Recorder, which basically records basic flight control positions, engine parameters, some information from the avionics. And as time has gone on and aircraft have become more advanced, it records a lot more of that technical avionics and control surface based data from the aircraft. Then in the 1950s, an Australian inventor named David Warren actually came up with the idea of adding a second black box to aircraft called a CVR, or a cockpit voice recorder, which not only records the voices of the crew themselves, but it also picks up all the other ambient sounds from the cockpit too. And in air accident investigations, this ambient noise is also a really important part of determining, for example, whether switches have been changed at any one point in time, the sounds of the engines, and other noises from the cockpit that can help determine the potential cause of an incident. But even as early as the 1980s, the NTSB, the National Transportation Safety Bureau in the USA, have been talking about introducing a third black box. So as well as the flight data, and as well as the voice and audio recordings from the cockpit, introducing a video recorder to capture video footage of what happens in the cockpit as well. After the Air India crash, the IATA Director General, a guy called Willie Walsh, he came out and said that there is a strong argument for video recorders in cockpits, and that it is quite possible that a video recording in addition to the cockpit voice recording would significantly assist the investigators. The NTSB have actually said that a third black box of video recording of the cockpit is actually their most wanted safety improvement in aviation right now. And it makes sense, doesn't it? Because a video recording of what's happening in the cockpit can obviously give you a lot more information of what's happening compared to what you would get from the flight data recorder or the cockpit voice recorder. So let's take a look at the pros, the reasons why having a third black box of video recording in the cockpit would be a good thing. The first is an obvious one. I mean, a video recording shows you things that you wouldn't otherwise be able to see. A flight data recorder can tell you that a switch has changed position. Maybe you might even hear the audio of a switch being moved on the cockpit voice recorder. But a video recording will show you if a switch was accidentally hit, for example, or if someone was potentially moving a switch and following the wrong procedure at the wrong time. The video recording simply gives you a little bit more information on top of what you already have, and potentially clear up any ambiguity from events that you know have happened, but you don't necessarily know how they've happened. The second are the benefits for future improvements and efficiencies in things like workflow procedures and how people go through checklists. For example, if someone's reading out a checklist and calling that they're changing switch A, and you hear a switch being moved on the cockpit voice recorder, but you can't see which switch is actually moved, if they call out switch A but they're actually touching switch B, then you can see there's a potential human error that's happened there, which could be a training issue with the crew, or it could also be the way that the checklist flow and procedures actually work. Those efficiencies can be found because you know that a procedure should have been followed, but it wasn't. And then there's also the speed of accident investigations and how quickly these reports come out. Now, families, obviously, of those who've been impacted by incidents like this want answers, and normally want answers quickly. And air traffic investigations can often take a long time, 2, 3, sometimes 4 years before final reports come out. Having a video recording of an incident could potentially speed up that process and get answers to those grieving families quicker.
So if the NTSB want it, if IATA want it, and if it will give us more information on air traffic incidents in a more timely manner, why don't some groups want it? Well, there are two groups who are currently strongly opposed to video recording in an aircraft cockpit, and that is the FAA and pilot unions. Now, pilot unions believe that it's an invasion of privacy, and the FAA believe that there are security and safety concerns when it comes to recording what pilots are doing. The first one of those concerns, then, privacy, is actually a really important one. Now, remember, as a pilot in the cockpit, this is basically your office, this is your desk space. And imagine if you did have a video camera recording everything that you do for every moment that you are actually at work at your job. A lot of the time when you're flying, you're not actually doing things which directly affect the operation and safety of the aircraft for which you're responsible. You're monitoring, sure, but a lot of the time you're not actually doing anything. So sometimes you might be doing things outside of that, like eating, for example, having a drink, having a conversation with a colleague. To have all of that monitored 24/7 by a video camera, to some is seen as a bit of an invasion of privacy, and worse still, a bit of an invasion of trust. The second concern then is the performance pressures that people may feel if they are being constantly monitored, especially in critical situations like an emergency situation. The last thing you want is a pilot to second guess themselves because of what they think someone will perceive based on what they're doing in the aircraft at any one time, when they should purely be focused on any emergency situation that may potentially arise. There's a chance that in some situations, it may be in the best interests of that situation for the pilot to slightly bend procedures or not do a checklist item. It might be, in their experience and in their training, the best way to resolve the emergency situation. But if they're second guessing that someone might be watching that, then it could potentially cause more problems than not by having that video camera in the cockpit. The last thing you want in the cockpit is hesitation. And what we don't want is pilots thinking that because they're being monitored, they're first of all thinking, how will something look on camera? And then they're acting and actually trying to resolve the situation. What we don't want is potentially for this footage to be used by the airlines against pilots to maybe put pressure on them for disciplinary reasons. And what we definitely don't want is for one tiny, microscopic, small event in the middle of a 10-hour flight to be leaked, to be taken out of context, and to be used by the media to come up with a story that has absolutely nothing to do with the intent of the pilot at the time they made that action. And it's those privacy and security reasons that are a big part of why the pilots' unions and the FAA are currently saying no to mandating the use of video cameras in cockpits. So in the world of general aviation, you know, smaller aircraft, recreational aviation, people flying for fun rather than commercial aircraft like you might be on with Qantas, Virgin, etc., recording with video cameras like this GoPro is actually pretty commonplace. Now, I've been recording my flights using cameras like this GoPro since pretty much I started flying. And a lot of that in the early days was because I wanted to, here on YouTube, share a lot of those experiences and show you what it's like in the world of general aviation. But I quickly found out from the very early days that not only is it a good way to get likes and stuff on the internet, but it's also a really good way for a pilot to debrief what's going on in the cockpit. I could see things like my landing techniques. You know, if I wasn't landing very well over a period of time and I couldn't work out why that was, the camera actually allowed me to see how I was manipulating the controls and improve technically the way that I was flying the aircraft. One time though, when recording did actually get me into a little bit of strife, was I did record a flight right back in my early days of flight training when I was flying with an instructor, and I published that flight to the internet without that instructor's permission. Now, nothing happened in that flight of consequence. There was nothing incriminating in there. But a day or two after I published it to the internet, I got a phone call from that instructor who was understandably pretty annoyed at me for having published that without their permission. Now, as I say, nothing incriminating happened, but their point was that they were currently at the point where they were looking for other jobs, commercial jobs in the airline industry. And potentially, if someone looked back at the footage and just saw one thing in there that they may take slightly out of context or think, well, I wouldn't have done it that way, so maybe this isn't the right person for us, that could unfairly bias their chances of employment in the future. Because whilst a video camera may be great at showing action, the one thing it's not very good at is showing intent.
Even whilst we might not know the intent behind what's happened, having video cameras recording in recreational aircraft has actually helped in air traffic investigations in the past. There was a horrible incident we had at the Avalon Air Show with an aerobatic plane crashing recently, and the footage from the camera that was installed inside that cockpit has been used to help the investigators. We also had a Robinson R66 helicopter here in Australia in 2023, which crashed. And it also had a camera recording the entire incident. And in the case of the Robinson R66, for example, we've had the final report already released not 2 years after the incident actually happened. So it's clear that having video cameras recording in general aviation aircraft can potentially speed up those reports. However, of course, it's not mandated. And whilst a lot of us pilots do use those video recordings to look back on our flights, there's no regulation that's ever going to come out that's going to mandate it, enforce it in the future. So then at first look, it feels kind of obvious that video recordings in the cockpit of commercial aircraft should be enforced, right? Well, I don't think it's quite that simple. In some ways, it's a bit like closed circuit television on our public streets. I mean, potentially cameras may stop someone from doing something bad in the first place. And if something bad does happen, maybe that camera can tell us exactly what has happened. But again, it doesn't show intent. And potentially what happens if that footage gets into the wrong hands, gets manipulated, and a different spin on what's actually happened is placed on top of that. As a pilot myself, I think that privacy in the cockpit is absolutely essential, and the trust that someone is going to be doing their job to the best of their ability, that trust really matters. Our pilots need to be able to be relaxed enough in performing their job that they're not going to be second guessing every single action they're doing because they're worried about the amount of scrutiny it's going to potentially get afterwards as someone goes through that video footage frame by frame. We want our pilots to be able to make fast decisions relying on their experience and not necessarily second guessing what someone's going to think when they watch back those decisions that have been made. And whilst the decisions that are being made by pilots should be up for analysis and review after the fact, absolutely, I mean, that's how we get better safety in our industry moving forwards, is 24/7 video monitoring of every single thing that happens in the cockpit the right way to do it? It's an interesting debate, and when I actually put this out on my Patreon account, I had 80% of people saying yes, a third video black box that records all activity in a cockpit should be mandatory, versus only 20% who said no, it should not be mandatory to have video recording in a cockpit. But what do you think? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. Do you think video recording should be mandated by the regulators, or do you think that's a step too far? Check out this next video right here. I think you'll really like this one. Thanks for watching.